Now we shall learn how to write your own custom extension methods. We have used dot where, we have used dot order by, so many of them we have used, single or default. Now it is time to write our own custom extension methods, so that they can act on a collection and it returns a collection acted upon by our own custom extension method. Consider this. Supposing we have a collection called ls and we write and we want to get a list of current year's blogs, then we should be able to write ls dot current year blogs, and this should return a collection of current year's blogs, so that a complex code can be written inside this extension method and it can be easily called on ls. So if you have a long processing and you want to reuse that at a number of points in your project, then you have no other way except to create your own extension method. In programming, you do not repeat code. Whenever you find that a code is now to be repeated, it's best to put it in, is it inside a function, or if a group of functions is to be repeated, it is best to put that into a class. And similarly, if you find that a lot many extension methods need to be repeated, then it is best to create your own custom extension method. Let us first of all have a look at the signature. A custom extension method is going to return a collection. So what will be the return type? We can safely write that the return type will be IEnumerable. The type of the collection that is to be ultimately returned, followed by the name of your, I'll write it bit smaller font, IEnumerable, followed by the name. I write current blogs. Then it has to act on a collection. So the C# syntax is to write the this keyword space IEnumerable and we can write this is one this space IEnumerable t call. Call is the identifier for the collection on which it is acting. This is a special sort of a syntax and it returns ultimately another IEnumerable of t. We can write some processing code and then return a collection of IEnumerable of t. This method must be static and put inside a static class, and it must be public also. This must be inside a static class and must be a public static method that returns IEnumerable t and takes an argument this I enumerable T call. This is the way you have to supply the argument for the extension methods. If you want to pass a parameter, then we can write I enumerable T my extension, this I enumerable T call. The parameters are, this is not treated as a parameter to the function, but it is a special syntax. So if I write an int I here, then the parameter is passed to this as I. And inside it you can do your old code, taking this I into consideration. Let us see how to call them. So if I have ls, then I can call ls my extension. I need not pass this parameter if I am C sharp or Visual Basic. Compiler will itself move it here. ls.myextension 6. So it will return me another collection obtained after processing this 6. Now let me show you how we use an how we create an extension method by using a concrete project. So first of all, you should create a basic MVC application with the controller and index as usual. When I run it, it's just displaying the hello world. So it's an empty application. And I have, however, added app underscore data already, and it's EDMX also. Now database designer, I'll show you what is the table. Show table data. There is a TBL blog consisting of an ID, blog heading and a blog date. So this is a blog date. Blog heading is a varchar, this is a date time, and ID is auto numbered. And I can come back to show you our EDMX. This is the simple EDMX. Now this is the data, and our objective is to create an extension method that returns a collection of all those blog objects which are in the current year. So for example, 2013, 2013, we should get these two records as a result. For this, I usually recommend putting all your extension methods into a separate folder or a separate namespace called utility. I have already created a folder called utility and put a class CO1 extensions into it. This class must be static, and let us begin to add our extension method to this one. The extension method must be public static. It returns I enumerable TBL blog because it is acting on a collection of TBL blog, and it is returning it to us. The name of the extension method is current year blogs, and it takes no argument. This argument is there, but it is not argument in the real sense. It just gives us a reference to the collection on which we are to act. This is a special syntax that is available to us that can give us the reference to the collection on which it is to act. This is not the argument in the real sense. Since there is nothing after comma or no comma is there, This extension method doesn't take any arguments, because current year is of course deducible from the system time. We can write return call.where x goes to x.blockDate, because x has a property called blockDate. Dot get value or default, this is required because block date is a nullable. So to convert a nullable into non-nullable, we can use a method that is already available on block date. If you see the list of methods, one is get value or default. So it will effectively convert it into a date time. And then we are writing x dot block date dot year is double equal to the current year. So we have written a very simple code that returns all the blocks of the current year. No complex logic is there. In fact, this one line could have been wrapped easily anywhere we need it. But my basic objective is to tell how to create them, so this will serve that purpose. The only thing you should remember, class must be static. Method must be static. This is the way you get a reference to the collection on which it is to act, and then do whatever inside to return a collection of TBL block. Now let us go and call it. We shall write a function called getCurrentBlocks, and inside that function we'll return a string for display purposes so that we can verify what is the output. And we can write here using entity models dot db blog entities, we are putting the complete path to our db blog, or we could have put using namespace entity models, whatever, because our db blog is inside entity models namespace. We have put on entity models into entity models namespace, so that is why we are using it. Then this is how we have used ctxt dot tbl blogs dot current year blogs. Now this is much neat, and if somebody wants details, then he can go to the C Hovan extensions file and view the details of this code. Especially if you need this code at a number of places, then this is the ideal way. Okay, let us finally execute the query, and we are returning blog date, blog heading. As usual, we have been doing. Let us run and verify. So this is the output that we have got. This is formatted as date time, blog, and blog. So two records were there and we have got both of them. So in case you need to write your own custom extension methods, this is the way you go. Put them inside static classes, use this to refer to the collection on which it is acting, and at the time of calling, do it like this. Let us write another extension method that returns all blogs on a particular topic. For this, what we can do is we can write an extension method. Let us call it fx. It takes the whole story I enumerable. The second argument will be string. So basically what we want to find is a list of all blogs in the heading of which this S appears. If you want to search all blogs for MVC, then we'll search the blog table for all those records where the blog heading contains MVC. So we'll write an extension method here. Within the same class we can write public, static, IEnumerable, TBL blog, get blogs by topic. And here this must be there, space IEnumerable, TBL blog, the collection on which it acts, and a string parameter called s. So we can write return call dot where TBL blog x goes to x dot contains x dot blog heading dot contains s. So we have written another extension method called get blogs by topic that takes one argument of type string. And we'll now come to home controller to call it. For this we can add private string get blogs true, and we can write using entity models dot db blog entity ctxt is equal to new, and here where query is equal to ctxt dot tbl blogs dot. The R extension method was get blogs by topic. It is available in IntelliSense, and I can pass the string, and this query is very neatly available to me. Next, since I have to display it, I'll just copy it and make a paste here. So you can have a look at this completed one. It gives me blogs, all blogs on MVC. And I'll have to make a change here also. I'll write get blogs to and call it here. So now if I run it, I'll get all the blogs that contain MVC. So there were two blogs, MVC problems and routing with MVC. And this is how it solves our problem. Although this is not ideal, because if we might have to work on it a little bit, but it generally illustrates the concept that how to create an extension method that takes one argument. We'll close it right now. In the next lecture, we'll study how to write our own SQL code in case we don't find sufficient extension methods, or in case we find difficulty in using extension methods. Then we can even directly write our SQL to the server. So we'll never find an opportunity where we may say ki now we made a mistake by starting our project in entities. It will never occur because all workarounds are there. Closing it right now. Thanks.